Welcome back, everybody. Today, I will be giving you my ranking of the songs from Season 1 of The Ghost and Molly McGee. I made a ranking of them at the end of Season 1A, but now I have even more songs to talk about. Plus, my opinions have changed quite a bit. I also want to set up some new rules. So this time, I won't be including any slam poems, little jingles, songs with no music, songs that aren't actually in the show like cut songs, theme song takeovers, or broken karaoke's. No reprises apart from one, since they're usually just the same quality as the original. I also won't be including the theme song, since that doesn't really count. Theme songs are just a normal part of TV, it feels weird to include it with the rest. I don't really say much about each of the songs, because there are over 40 of them, and I don't want to stress myself out too much. Also, I should say that this is just my opinion, and with that said, let's start from the bottom and make our way to the top.
Dad, don't you turn into silly McGee. Don't bring back the boy that you used to be. You've lived as...
Twin Trouble is my least favorite episode of the show, and this is one of the reasons. It's not bad, I think the animation is kinda cool. It's just kinda... eh.
Listen to the story I'm about to tell about a man from Brighton I know so well. He was big and strong.
Again, it's just sorta boring. I don't really have any strong feelings about it, positive or negative.
It's nice to be nice, as my mother once said. It's good to be good.
It's okay, nothing amazing, but enjoyable.
Like a phoenix from the ashes, rising up.
Okay, from here on out, all these songs are good. This was really nice, especially after that long hiatus of no new songs.
I'm just a red-blooded, hard-working, regular guy. I don't need no caviar, just give me burgers and fries.
This one is pretty cool, and I'll listen to it from time to time. My only issue is that it feels really out of place. Like, we already knew about Kenny Starr for the episode to work, and there was already another song in it with Least Expected. It's pretty fun, but when you put it up against the rest of the songs, it falls a bit short.
No one makes my heart dance like you do. Nothing less than a death to a sport.
This is pretty fun, but why the heck is Scratch attacking these random people? Andrea was the only one who was screwing with them. Win-win-win-win-win-win-win. This music is fun, and I love Sharon in it. Win.
I'm gonna make you mad. I'm gonna fix all your feelings. I'm not giving up. I'm like a free chain of love. And I'm
very... Ashley Bush is a great singer, so every time Molly sings, it's great. But like most of the songs down here, it just isn't as good as the rest. I love the sitcom opening style, and seeing Molly and Scratch in matching t-shirts and laughing together really inhabifies me.
With a bad boy biker, I fell in love.
Her heart was aloft.
His black...
I don't really know what to say here, except that I really like it. Yeah, let's move on.
Together forever, my best friend and me. We're sticking together for the rest of eternity.
One that started it all. Again, Ashley Bush is a great singer. I listen to this on Spotify like every 2 days. It gave a great first impression for the quality of the songs in this show.
Just like that kombucha, keep on sipping and you'll see that I'm great. So won't you take a second chance on me?
And now, we have the second song of the show. It's got a nice beat to it, and some of the visual gags are pretty cool. It's just really neat.
Give give what you can. Just a couple hours of your day can help make the world a better place. Lend a hand.
It may not be as good as the first Just Give, but it's still great. It's so awesome seeing everyone at Ryzen working together due to the influence of the McGees. Without this, Homer's Where the Haunters wouldn't have hit the same. Super fun, but I wish it went on for a bit longer. I still really like it though. First song on this list that makes me do a little dance in my chair. It's really fun, and the toxic mole joke is the funny.
Abraham Lincoln stood 6'4". He kept us united through the Civil War because he believed every person had the right to be unchained, liberated, completely free. So he rocked the...
This was at my number 2 spot last time, but it's gone down quite a bit now. Not because my opinion of it has gone down, but because my views on other songs have gone up. It's still really cool and has a nice Hamilton vibe to it.
There's a brand new craze on the radio dial. Everybody's dancing in the produce aisle. Turn up the stereo and go like this. So come on, do the turn up twist.
This just makes me smile. It's so great to see everyone in have a fight, even if that's bad news for Scratch.
The goat,
I love the vaporwave aesthetic. It's really cool how all these songs can have different styles, but they still really work well together. All in all, very fun.
The camera's rolling and the lights are lit.
That's as close to in focus as they're gonna get.
There are not...
This awakens a lot of nostalgia for me, from when I would make home movies with my friends and siblings. Seeing all four of our pals hanging out is really fun.
We could start out with the super happy picnic at the park, then hit up the aquarium and watch them feed a shark. It's sunny, it's Saturday, let's go out and make this an awesome best friend's day. There's archery.
Pure unfiltered fun. Just non-stop silly stuff with Molly. I love it. Also, I have a Twitter account where I post the same clip from it every Saturday. You should go check that out.
Frustration, I'm not having any fun.
Frustration,
that was touching my tongue.
Frustration,
but I won't, I can't get it.
I love you both, but this creeping is pathetic.
Frustration.
These songs are getting so good now. I'll always be singing along to this.
I get a whiff, and all at once, I'm yearning. Your oily fragrance puts me in the mood. My heart goes pitter, pitter, pat for that vat of liquid fat. Oh, I'm deep in love with deep fried food.
I have a confession to make, guys. More often than not, I find myself singing this in the shower. This song goes hard. Dana Snyder is a great singer, and I really hope we'll see more singing from Scratch in season 2.
That's exactly where the city needs your bulbous derriere. Don't give up, go back to City Hall. We know the...
We just been through another hiatus, and this was super great to come back to. I really hope more episodes in the future, and therefore the songs, will focus on other citizens of Brighton, like how we got ones on Mayor Brunson and Weird Larry. As far as I know, this is the only song to incorporate Molly's theme in it, and that's really cool. I also really love when these songs do cool stuff with the animation instead of it just being the normal lighting and backgrounds.
Who's got the goods?
Do you have what it takes to lead us?
Who's got the goods?
Do you have passion in your heart?
Who's got the goods?
I love the guitar on this, and again, Ashley Bush does a great performance. This one just really slaps. To be honest, everything I just said about who's got the goods applies here as well. There's not much else I can say.
Good luck, bad luck. Two cosmic forces diametrically opposed.
This is fun. I love seeing good things happen to Libby. She deserves everything, if we're being honest. All the zoom-ins here, and just the visuals in general, are great. Especially with Scratch in his little mailman outfit. I don't really know what to say anymore. I love it. The music, the lyrics, everything. Let's just get on with it.
Something good's gonna come, yeah. When you least expect it.
This was a great way to end the episode, although I can't find the Korean lyrics from the beginning anywhere. So if there's anyone who knows Korean watching this, please comment that. Still awesome though.
Just give what you can. It's time to prove you're not a jerk. Come help your fellow man. Just give.
Another big change from my original list. This was at number one before. But despite it falling in my ranking, I still love it. It's still really funny. And again, Ashley Burch does a great performance. And I just really love it.
I can change the world. I can make it better if I try. All I ever wanna do is inhappify. Inhappify.
Here we go, top 10. It's kind of surprising it took this long for an Inhappify song to happen. But regardless, this shows off Molly's cheerful, Inhappifying personality incredibly.
There will be Christmas and Brighton after all.
We're stringing lights up,
protecting every hall.
Every hall will slather
every... Unironically, one of my favorite Christmas songs. It really pulls at my heartstrings. Although the gift they give Mr. Davenport changes appearance between shots. That's weird. It's so beautiful to see all the McGee's, including Scratch, working super hard to help Pete. This song is just so incredibly sweet.
One must be vanquished so that there can be only one best friend.
I can't help but hear the final countdown when listening to this. Aside from that, it's just another really cool song. This is awesome. This is great. I love it a lot. Especially with Molly going insane being absolutely hilarious.
Killjoy. Killjoy.
This is the best song in terms of the animation. I love this style so much. It also shows off Jinx's character really well.
The sun is shining, it's a beautiful day. Everything is totally normal.
Normal.
Both of us have homes at which we could play. Cause everything is totally normal. Suspicious.
Here's the one for my favorite episode of the show. It shows off Molly's fears really well. And Libby not buying it for a second is great. Her and Molly's friendship is seriously amazing.
Flowers sprouting up every step I take. I leave a trail of blue koalas in my way.
This was an absolutely amazing final song. It's so perfect for who Molly is and what the show is about. I adore it.
It's my best friend's bat mitzvah. A magical Jewish soiree. It's my best friend's bat mitzvah. Oh, Scratch, prepare to be blown away.
I can see the mashed potato bar now.
Sparkling.
Now, this and number one, I honestly consider to be perfection. Ashley Burch and Dana Snyder give spectacular performances here. It's insane. And seeing just how highly Molly views Libby is amazing. And speaking of how Molly sees her...
What do I do? Should I tell her the truth?
Tell her what now?
Should I just avoid her? That would destroy her.
Sure, that'll do. Bonus points.
I'll be unhappy. whichever choice I choose. It's a lose-lose.
Yeah.
This song is perfect. The performances are perfect. The music is perfect. The look of it all is perfect. And most of all, the lyrics are perfect. This song perfectly shows Molly's dilemma. It easily takes the place of the greatest song so far from The Ghost and Molly McGee.
I just can't throw away a best friend. I refuse. But I don't know what to do. It's a lose-lose.
So, there you go. My ranking of the songs from Season 1 of The Ghost and Molly McGee. Not much else I have to say, except to tell you to like and subscribe to Make Me Smile, and I'll see you later.
The Ghost and Molly McGee.